just keep going up. So we have 1,000 right there. Do I hear 2,000? 2,000 right there. Can I get 3,000?
Well, first of all, the fact that they did this absolutely floored all of us, really.
Oh, we're just getting started, baby. We're just getting started.
Yeah, I wasn't sure how well it was going to be executed. I wasn't sure at how well it was going to be accepted.
Right up there. Right up there on the left.
Oh, that's awesome. I absolutely love it. Cool.
You would see, like, on the left side, these painters, and you're like, why are they here? Like, what are they doing?
My doubts dissipated after about 10 minutes, having met the artists.
We're there for the families to help them until the end, and they know that we're here for them.
My family said, where is Laura? Everybody said, the lady with the green dress and the red hair.
That's me. The red-haired lady that was here, She came in from Argentina. She stayed for a wedding with her daughter. Her daughter was 3 years old at the time. They were staying in Hallandale, and her daughter didn't feel well. So she took her to Joe DiMaggio Hospital.
When the doctor made the MRI, sadly, he said, sorry, your daughter has cancer. I was thinking in that moment that what I can do.
They started doing my treatment, and one day they asked my mom for money, and my mom didn't bring a lot of money. She only brought like $500 just for us.
A child with cancer today can cost in the upwards of $1 million for 1 year if they stay in remission. One child for 1 year, upwards of $1 million.
And she's like, I don't have this type of money with me. And the doctor was like, well, I can't do anything.
In 51 years, we have never refused long-term treatment for a child with cancer. We've never, never turned any child away in 51 years.
And my mom's like, what do you mean? And the doctor's like, I can't keep on giving your daughter the treatment. So, okay, hold on. I usually never cry. Okay. So, as we're leaving the hospital, my mom's just crying her eyes out, and we were sitting on the side of the hospital, and this lady comes up to my mom and says, call this lady, she'll help you.
And that was 15 years ago. Her daughter was 3, she's now 18. And many children, I have to tell you, are being turned away in mid-treatment from other local hospitals. One patient came in with $1 million in insurance to another local hospital. That was used up in maybe 2 weeks, $1 million insurance. They were told they had to come up with more money, and they said, we don't have it. The doctor said, we can't treat your child any longer. And they told her to come here because they know that we never say no to any. We don't permit a child's life to be measured by the dollar. Where's the humanitarianism today?
Ah, that's a beauty.
That thing's awesome.
Look at that thing. Oh my God, that's so fun looking.
That's got a little studio on there for you, dude.
Yeah, you could definitely paint in there.
Did we collaborate together?
We collaborated together. When did we collaborate together?
Was it a Mardi Gras painting?
No, it was in the studio. Isn't this
no, I know, but I'm talking about for a...
For live?
For a, like, yeah, like a live thing. I can't remember when the first time was.
No, Mardi Gras.
It was Mardi,
no,
Gras? Was it Mardi Gras?
No, no, it was before that. It was, no, Flow Tribe. Then we did the Mardi Gras stuff, painted that, and then since then we've kind of just been like, you know, we'll pop up at different gigs and, you know, get together and paint live, you know. I mean, I think it's kind of like being in a band almost, you know, like you get to kind of feed off the other person and you learn kind of their style and their technique and the way they do things to where you can kind of almost, like I can lead you into something that I know you're going to do, you know, before you do it, you know.
Right.
I mean, it's a dance, you know.
So then we went to Sundance. We got an opportunity to go up there and paint with this group that brought Mardi Gras to Sundance.
We were there, you were sitting there filming us, and so TJ ended up painting you into the painting, you know, which so obviously you were a little more enticed as to what the hell is going on here. And, you know, you guys, I believe, talked for a while about stuff, and you told him about the project.
Yeah, he asked me if we ever painted charity type stuff.
Florida is a leading state with incidence of cancer. Cancer is 100 different diseases, and there are 5 different forms of leukemia. That's the number one disease for children. Brain tumors are really coming up. It's number 2 where children are concerned. We just got a family that came in from Venezuela. A child had brain tumor. I mean, and rhabdomyosarcoma, it just goes on and on.
Having worked with the Children's Caring Cancer Center, I've gotten to see some of the parents and know some of the parents whose children are battling this. And as a parent, I will tell you that I personally would do anything possible to help my child if my child was sick.
I always wanted to work for needy families. When I started this, I had 2 patients and 5 doctors, and I was at Jackson for 30 years. We became the Children's Cancer Caring Center, and when I left Jackson, we had 500 children on our books. And we are the only free treatment center for children with cancer in the southeastern United States. That was the premise on which I started it, that every penny went where it was supposed to go.
I personally lost 2 cousins to cancer when I was very young. And then I had another cousin when he was just 13. He was affected by bone cancer and tragically had to lose his leg, but he kept his life.
Oh, God. Okay. So sometimes I'm asked, why do I have so much passion for the Children's Caring Cancer Center? It strikes a very emotional chord within me. When I was 12 years old, I had a friend who lived 3 doors down, who was 13. Mark got leukemia when he was 12. And a year later, Mark was gone.
This is what we're dealing with, really. It's indescribable.
sometimes seem hopeless, and it's really exciting when, you know, you have a chance to make a difference in somebody's life that is struggling at that level. When things, you know, seem lost and, you know, there isn't a light at the end of the tunnel, that, you know, that you can bring that to them.
We don't have 100% success rate. We lose some. But for the some that we lose, it's more than made up by the ones that we can save. And we have seen children that we have helped go off to school, graduate high school, graduate college, go to post-baccalaureate degrees. We have a doctor who was a former patient as a child, a surgeon who's now on the board.
We have our own summer oncology camp called Camp Fiesta. You see the picture on the yes. wall there, Camp Fiesta? It's a small camp, but it's like the second family to all of the patients.
As that day, like, you don't understand how happy I am, because the things that Lee does, not only for me, but for all the children, it's something completely different and something that most people, like, now to this day, don't really do.
I think probably everyone has been on this earth to help someone else all the time. If people ask you what your life mission is, I mean, mine's to paint, you know? But if I can save lives and paint at the same time, I mean, that's like kind of win-win, you know? And we get to do what we love, and we get to, you know, spread our, you know, spread the magic, you know?
I'm very excited and hopeful that, you know, we can get engaged with more organizations and fundraising events, and hopefully, you know, continue to work side by side and help people who, you know, need the love and need the inspiration.
With using our talents, help get those charities more support to where they can help more other people that can't get the help for themselves so they can survive, you know? I mean, we probably have, 40 or 50 charities hit us up a year for donations and stuff like that. And we give as much as we can, but when the director brought it up, it was like, oh, here's a new fire to, like let's really take this next level now and really go after a way to help people.
Part of the appeal for me was that, you know, you live in Florida, and we don't get to do a lot of things in Florida.
Now, as of who I am, I can do anything and I can accomplish anything because of what Lee did for me. So that's why I like giving back to, like, not only to, like, the cancer organization, but, like, I also help, like, other people, like, at school, or, like, my friends come over and I'm always there for them, because it's someone that was there for me, now I want to be there for someone else.
I think it behooves all of us to step up and make this world a better place. Whether you're helping a sick child, whether you're helping somebody who needs your help in any which way, I think it behooves all of us to do our fair share. Whether it's going into a senior citizen home and getting people to smile because of your kindness, whatever it is, I think we all owe it to our community at large to make it better.
People can write checks, you know, we can't write checks, we're not in a position to, but we can give what we have, and what we have is, we have art, you know, so we can give art and try to do what we can to give back and help people out, you know?
You know, we can't necessarily, like, give money, but we're talented, so we can bring this talent to raise money for the event, and so we can kind of vicariously help save lives of kids and everyone, you know, and people that are in need, man.
We donate paintings to charities, you know, all year long, so you kind of have to pick and choose which charities that, you know, you're going to go with. And it's always, for me, anything related to, you know, kids or instruments for kids or kids that are sick or, you know, but it's not going to be the golf charity.
This is all of you, if you're not in the photo. Let's give him a huge round of applause,
TJ. I mean, it feels good to donate a piece of art to a charity.
Of course.
And, like, you know, and be part of it, and to like, you know, pretty much entertain these people. I would really enjoy it.
Extended periods of time trying to be in it. Alright, 4,000, we have 4,000 from Kent, right here 5,000, right? Anything between 5,000 right here is going to get 6,000 for this one. We got our final item here, folks, so if you want to dig deep for this one, your last opportunity, regret it if you don't. Remember, all going to the amazing families and the children, so we're at 5,000, looking for 6,000 right now. It's a priceless work of art by two incredible gentlemen, so thank you, TJ and Alex. We have 6,000 right there, 7,000 right now, 7,000. Kent is currently in this, he wants this one. It's 7,000. Looking for 7,000. We're at 6 with Ken right now, so 7,000. Looking for 7,000 for this one. We're going to get started with the show here. Last opportunity. There's someone bidding in the front. 65! Wow! 65, baby. Looking for 7. 69.99. 65 right here. That's 75. 67. 65. 7. Looking for 7. Now we're going to wrap this up. So looking for 7.65 here. We have 7 for Ken. 75 right here. 75. We've got 7 right there going once.
No, no.
7 going twice.
Stop. Anything?
8,500. Okay. 8,500. Going once. 8,500. Going twice. And sold the Kent Musket. Yeah. Give a huge round of applause. That was, yes, $100,650. All the shirts. Thank you.
So it's like, it's one of those things where it's like, if, you know, if the right help is there, then you can beat it, you know what I'm saying? And the question is just the people that can't get the help, you know, how do you help people get help?